Jeff Foxworthy, and this is the show that asks the question, are you smarter than a fifth grader? We give grown-ups a chance to prove that they are indeed smarter than a 10-year-old, and if they can prove it, they can win $1 million. All right, over here is my class, Laura. Class, you ready to meet our new student?
He's a 34-year-old professional poker player who graduated from public school 81 in the Bronx. Please welcome Alex Alfred. Alex, how are you?
Hey, guys.
Hey, man.
Doing well. You professional poker player.
Yes.
Really, you dog.
Who knew, man?
You get to do that for a living.
Yes, I do.
Was that your ambition when you were attending PS
81? When I was in PS 81, I would have loved to have played a game.
Yeah.
As a career, absolutely. Poker, I didn't even know what it was back then.
Yeah, good for you. And here's a picture of you back from those days.
I'm the one on the right.
And you're smiling like you got trip aces right there.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, well, welcome to our show.
Thank you.
These guys are gonna take the same quiz.
All right, guys.
And you can actually cheat off of them. Pick one of them and let's play.
Oh, gosh. Here we go with Laura.
We're here to win it.
All right. Laura's hand just shot up and I was all about it right away, so.
All right, Alex, let me tell you how we play. On the board, 10 subjects. They range from first grade through the fifth grade level.
Okay.
The first question you answer correctly is worth $1,000. The last subject, if you answer correct, is worth $500,000.
Right?
Answer all these, we will give you an 11th question. Okay. It is from grade school. You get it correct, you win $1 million. If at any point this gets to be too scary, if you don't want to answer questions normally asked to 6-year-olds through 10-year-olds, all right, you can take whatever money you've won up to that point, you can drop out of school, but you have to promise me right up front, when you do drop out of school, that you're gonna look into the camera and tell the entire world, I am not smarter than a fifth grader. You got a deal?
No objections, Jeff, no objections.
All right, Alex, you ready to play?
I'm ready to play,
Jeff.
Let's
find out if Alex is smarter than a fifth grader. All right, Alex. Pick a subject.
All right. Should I go grammar or history? What do you think? Grammar?
Well, I would pick grammar just because it's first grade.
Let's start a little bit hard. Let's start with history.
History. For $1,000, Alex, here's the question. What is the first name of former U.S. President Taylor? What is the first name of former U.S. President Taylor? While Laura writes her answer, let me remind you, Alex, during the course of the game, you have two cheats. At one point in the game, you can peek at their paper. If you like their answer, you can use it. If you don't, you can go with your own. And one time during the game, you may copy your classmate's paper, but you have to take the answer that they have written down. Or if you think you know the answer, once during the game, you can use a save. That means if you answer incorrectly, but your classmate at the podium answers correctly, they can save you. And Laura has already written down an answer. She is locked in. What are you thinking, Alex?
All right, it's not Steve, it's not, or is it John Taylor?
Steve?
Yeah.
I don't think we've had a president named Steve, have we?
I feel like there was a Zachary Tyler, and I don't want to make sure that, and it's not John Taylor. Okay.
All right, you
I don't
want
to peek now. No,
you can
I feel
copy.
Like I want to say that. I'm gonna answer the question. I'm gonna say Zachary.
Okay.
95% on this. 95% sure, and that's just not good.
May we see what Laura said? What's the first name of former U.S. President Taylor? Laura said Zachary.
Within it, that's all right.
The bad news is, if that's not the right answer, you just lost your save.
That's fine.
And you have cashed your chips in.
Yes, I have. I've pushed them in the pot.
But Laura's right, and you're right, and you got $1,000.
What's up, girl?
Yeah.
you got $1,000. Pick another subject. Let's go for $2,000.
I'm gonna take, I'm gonna go with first grade grammar. Knock it out the box.
For $2,000, Alex, here's your first grade grammar question. What is the root word of the word longest? What is the root word of the word longest? Laura has locked in her answer.
She locked it in pretty quick, too.
She did.
But I really want to save those cheats for when I need them.
Alex, let me tell you this. Out of your classmates over here?
Yeah.
They're 4 for 4. They've got it right.
Are you serious? You guys are real excited. I mean, when your hand shot up, I feel very confident with the whole group. What is the root word of the word longest? This is first grade. It has to be long. I am not going to use a cheat. I will say long.
Gotta say long. What did Laura say? Long. You're both right. You got $2,000. Nice work, Laura.
Your classmates can only help you 2 questions at a time.
Time to pick another classmate, Alex.
All right. I know you want it, but I'm going to go with him.
Jacob.
You guys are coming. I'm going to go with him.
Hey.
Jacob, how are you?
Not bad.
All right, you got $2,000, Alex. Let's turn it into $5,000. Pick another subject.
All right, well, first, if I can talk to Jacob real quick. What are your favorite subjects out of what's left?
Social studies, geography, anything that's science, anything that's math.
Okay.
So that covers all of them but one.
Right.
Alex, yes, sir, you've got a first grade geography question, right, and you got a fifth grade geography question.
That's true. This is true.
Yeah, so yeah, you probably want to get the hard ones out of the way now.
I mean, do you want to go? And you do know by hard ones, he's referring to the ones normally answered by 10-year-olds instead of 6-year-olds.
Yes, I'm aware of this. I have not studied this stuff in a good 20 years, so. So I'm gonna go with first grade US geography, and then maybe we'll move on to the other.
First grade US geography for $5,000. Alex, the question is, in terms of land area, what is the smallest US state? In terms of land area, what is the smallest U.S. state? If it makes you feel any better, Jacob's already locked in.
It does make me feel better. Well, I'm gonna talk this out. My immediate instinct is Rhode Island, but I just need to do a quick scan of the rest of the states, knock off Alaska and California, you know, and all that stuff, and Texas is not in there.
Yeah, I think you could probably
eliminate
Texas.
Those. So let me just do a quick mental scan of the United States of America. Let's see, Florida doesn't creep in there. Hawaii would be the closest one, but when you add up all that land mass, that gets a little tricky there. Rhode Island's pretty smart. Okay, I've pretty much made up my mind that it's Rhode Island. Now let me examine my options if I want to work with my friend Jacob here. Oh, it's so easy, guys. I know, it's easy.
Right,
but
Alex,
one mistake and you're gone, so you gotta make sure.
You got 2 cheats left.
And I've got
you can peek at his paper, you can copy his paper.
Okay.
You can answer the question if you're wrong. Jacob answered it pretty quickly. If he's right, he can save you. What do you want to do?
He sure did. All right, I've made up my mind. I'm not gonna use any cheats. It's Rhode Island. Lock it up. Don't do it to me, man.
When you were thinking about Hawaii,
No.
When you think about adding them all up, you're still thinking Rhode Island's smaller than that?
Yes, I am.
I'm going to tell you if you're right, right after this. Welcome back to Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader? Our contestant, Alex Alfred from Riverdale, New York, is playing for $5,000. The question, in terms of land area, what's the smallest U.S. state? You said Rhode Island.
Please.
Okay. It's Rhode Island. You got $5,000. All right, Alex, here's the good news. Okay. You have $5,000.
Okay.
You have your save and both of your cheats left.
Okay.
The bad news is, out of the remaining subjects on the board, none of them are third grade Texas Hold'em. You married, Alex?
Not yet, but I do have a beautiful fiance in the audience.
You do?
In the audience. Yes, I do.
Where's your fiance?
Just pick the hottest one.
Oh, yeah. You do have a beautiful fiance. You didn't win her in a poker game, did you?
No, but I almost lost her.
Uh-huh. All right, pick another subject. Let's play for $10,000.
Okay.
Animal science!
Okay. Sorry, give me one moment. I just got to decide between animal science.
You know what
and
you can do? You can go home right now with $5,000.
That's an option, huh?
Yeah.
No. Okay. I'm gonna save math. Let's do second grade animal science.
Second grade animal science.
I'm not very confident about this one, Jeff.
Well, if you're gonna win $1 million, you gotta
tackle
it. I gotta
get through
it
anyhow.
Point.
Exactly.
All right, here we go, Alex. The question is.
Come on.
How many legs does a butterfly have? How many legs does a butterfly have?
That was really fast on Jacob's part.
Jacob has already locked in.
It's like 6 or 8. Wow, okay.
Now, does that make you feel better or worse?
Makes me feel much better that he answered
that quickly.
That means that I am less confident than Jacob is. So I'm gonna copy Jacob's answer.
Okay.
Wow.
So what you're saying is,
yes,
$10,000 is riding on a 10-year-old.
Not a 10-year-old, a very bright, enthusiastic, quick, I know my stuff 10-year-old. Give me another high five. That's my man.
You sure your game isn't roulette? Poker, right?
It's poker. Supposed to get my money
Let's
in when the odds are in my favor.
Let's see what Jacob said. How many legs does a butterfly have? Jacob said 6. What was your guesses?
It was 6 or 8. I think 8's just too many. They don't need 8.
Or
they're fine
8.
With 6. They got wings.
If you would have said 8, you would have been wrong. A butterfly has 6 legs. You have $10,000.
Yes! I'm talking about.
You know
Jacob,
what?
Thanks, man.
You're
what's that?
You won another pot, you got $10,000. Pick another classmate, let's try to turn it into $25,000.
I'm gonna wait for you. I'm going with you, Alana.
Alana, come on up here.
I'll get to you, I'll get to you. I'll get to you too. We're gonna get there. Hi, Alana.
I like your confidence telling the rest of them I'll get to you.
Yes,
you
think, I'll be there
you think
and
you're gonna be
great.
Here down the road. I like that.
All that stuff.
All right, here we go. You've got $10,000. This question is very important because right now, if you miss it and you don't get saved, you go home with nothing.
That's right.
You get this next question right, no matter what happens the rest of the game, you go home with $25,000, okay? Pick a subject, Alex.
Okay. Let's go with fourth grade math.
Fourth grade math. Fourth grade math for $25,000. Here's the question. What is the numeric value of the Roman numeral L? You like this one.
I like it.
What is the numeric value of the Roman numeral L? All right, Alex.
All right.
Alana's locked in.
Great, I'm not using any cheats. The answer is 50. Don't give me that look.
I want to find out what the rest of the class said. Class, what do you think the numeric value of the Roman numeral L is?
Oh,
they said 50.
Okay.
You're right.
I am.
You got $25,000. We're playing for $50,000 right after this. Smarter than a fifth grader, we are playing for $50,000. No matter what else happens, The minimum you can go home with is $25,000. Pick another subject, try to turn it into 50, will you, Alex?
Okay, let's go with third grade social studies.
Third grade social studies. For $50,000, here's your third grade social studies question. How many justices serve on the U.S. Supreme Court? How many justices serve on the U.S. Supreme Court? Alana has locked in her answer.
This is a little bit tricky. Gosh, darn it.
You're okay. Looking about as confident as a guppy in a shark tank right now.
I know we got Ginsburg and Thomas. They just elected two. And then there's Scalia. There's that old guy.
The old guy.
I know it's an odd number. No, I'm basically stuck on it's either 7 or 9 right now.
You have a peek left, Alex.
This is true.
You can peek at Alana's answer.
Okay. I have a peek and a save.
And you have a save, meaning, I mean, sounds like you're down
to
a couple.
Yeah, the thing is she really didn't look that confident when she was writing that answer down. I was able to just see a little bit of her face there. And I'm stuck on it's either 7 or 9, so I really just need a moment to try and go through some of these names here. And if I come up with more than 7, that really helps me out.
That's a smart theory. I like that.
You like that? I'm trying to get visual with this whole thing. I'm literally picturing them at the State of the Union. They were sitting there all, you know, not clapping.
You can peek at her paper. I mean, you can see what she said.
I know.
If you like it, you can go with it.
Yeah.
If not, you can go
that
with
That would
yours.
Just potentially throw in some doubt, though. And I feel like I want to save that for something else, but there's no point in saving. So
unfortunately, in this game, we can't really use the bluff, can we?
No. I can't just say I'm all in and then you guys fold and I get it right. Doesn't really work out like that. No, please. All right, I am literally just going to take 30 seconds of quiet time, and I'm just going to go through. All right, so you got Scalia. Yeah, you guys hang out.
You want to put your heads on your desk and I'll read to you for a little while?
Scalia, two that just came in. You had Ginsburg, you had Clarence Thomas.
Can you just pick an answer, man?
You're going to make a great ex-wife someday. You can walk out of here with $25,000.
Well, it's the same thing. I gotta answer it.
What do you think?
Okay, I'm gonna answer. Let's say 7.
We waited a long time for that 7. Alex, it's not a lucky 7. That is not the right answer. The correct answer to how many justices serve on the Supreme Court is 9. Your only hope right now is that Alana saves you. May we please see Alana's answer for $50,000. She said 9.
I got saved! I thought I was out. I forgot all about the save. Woo! Alana, wow. Thank you.
Alex, you got $50,000.
Okay.
We're gonna play for $100,000 when we come back.
All right.
Coming up.
Jacob, thanks, man.
Yeah.
Jacob helped him. Alana saved him.
I got saved!
Can our class help Alex ace this exam?
Give me that money!
So we can finally give someone $1 million.
You're all in.
Freaking me out, Jeff.
Or are you smarter than a fifth grader? When we return.
Welcome back to Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader? Our contestant, Alex Alfred from Riverdale, New York, has won $50,000. Thanks to a 10-year-old girl.
Thanks to a 10-year-old girl. Not often I can say that.
For her.
I'd have been
out
of here.
You'd be home by now.
Yeah, I'd be in traffic.
You'd be in traffic. You're about to play for $100,000. Wow. Pick another classmate.
All right, I'm saving you for the end. I'm going with you, buddy.
Spencer! How are you, Spencer?
Good.
Alex, you've got $50,000.
Okay.
You're playing for $100,000. Pick your next subject.
All right. I'm gonna go with, I'm gonna go with measurements. I'm not very good at measurements, I'll tell you right
well,
now.
It's a second grade question. I can understand your apprehension. For $100,000, Alex, here's the question.
Good luck, Spencer.
If March 1st falls on a Wednesday, on what day of the week does April 1st fall?
That's a great question.
If March 1st falls on a Wednesday, on what day of the week does April 1st fall?
Okay.
Spencer has locked in his answer. Let me tell you what your options
are. Okay.
You have a peak left, but if you use your peak,
okay,
you can't walk away. You got to give us an answer.
Right.
If it's incorrect, you go home with $25,000.
Okay. I think I should be able to get this one. There's 31 days in March. So let me go through. So the 1st is a Wednesday. That means the 8th is a Wednesday, which means the 15th is a Wednesday, which means the 22nd is a Wednesday. The 29th is a Wednesday. 30th is a Thursday. The 31st is a Friday. There are 31 days in March. That's the tricky thing. Yes, there are. So 31st is a Friday, which should make April 1st a Saturday.
Your fiance has a very serious face. $50,000 is a lot of money.
We have a honeymoon coming up.
Buy a heck of a honeymoon for $50,000.
He knows this one.
Saturday is the answer. Freaking me
May
out.
May we Jeff. See Laura's answer, please? It's for $100,000. Laura said Friday. Let's see what Spencer said. Saturday. You said Saturday. If March 1st is a Wednesday, then April 1st falls on a Saturday. You have $100,000. You know what, I gotta say, I loved your approach to that. Going through the week and adding them up. I wouldn't have thought of that.
Well, can I just share something real quick? I play poker. It's all about making the right decision. And if you go with just your instinct as an impulse, that'll screw you up all the time. If you overanalyze, that'll screw you up. But if you combine your instinct with your analysis, you usually make the right decision, so that's how I'm playing this game. And when that fails, pray.
For anybody that just heard that information, that's $21.95. Send the check to Alex. All right, I gotta ask you something. You say instinct's important. Is your instinct right now telling you to walk away with $100,000? Because that's how much you have.
My instinct is, let's see the next question. If I don't like it, probably walk away.
All right. Pick your next subject.
England.
I'll go with world geography.
Fifth grade, world geography. Alex, this question is worth $175,000. Before I show it to you, what's the most money you ever won playing poker?
I won a hair less than $200,000 once.
Wow. Wow. By the way, did you report the $200,000 to the IRS?
Absolutely.
You just did. All right, for $175,000, may we see the question?
Make it easy.
The Strait of Magellan runs through the southern tip of what continent? Fifth grade question. The Strait of Magellan runs through the southern tip of what continent? Spencer is locked in. You can still peek at Spencer's paper. Tell me what you're thinking, Alex.
Oh, it's either Africa or South America.
If you peek at his paper, you can't walk away. Right now, you can walk away. You've got $100,000. If you answer and it is incorrect, you drop down to $25,000. That means you give back $75,000.
Well, narrowed it down to two. One's the Strait of Magellan, the other is the Cape of Good Hope. Cape of Good Hope is Africa. This tells me that the Strait of Magellan is in South America. Wow, this is,
You can walk away right now with $100,000. Where are you getting married?
Santa Barbara, California.
Nice place.
Beautiful.
Not cheap.
No.
$100,000 pays for a very nice wedding. $25,000, justice of the peace, and some flowers from the convenience store.
I'm gonna use my peek.
You want a peek?
Yes.
Lock in peek for me.
Peek.
Alex, your classmate Spencer said South America.
It's South America. Give me the money.
Feel good about it?
Gonna get run through the ringer now. Tell me, Jeff.
You're all in.
Yes, sir.
With a 10-year-old.
Mostly in. I've got 25,000 in chips, just in case.
No, you've got 175,000.
Yeah! There we go. Let's get some in. Thank you, brother. Wow. Awesome.
Brilliant.
175.
Hold on one more second.
Holding.
Because you have no more cheats left.
Oh, that's right.
Your fiance's got $175,000. Nice wedding, nice honeymoon, nice start in life.
Yep.
What's going through your head right now?
Part of it's taking it, part of it is third grade English is third grade English, you know.
Let me ask you this. If he loses it and goes down to 25,000, are you gonna be mad?
No, it's 25,000 we didn't have an hour ago.
That's my girl.
Your classmates can't help you anymore, Alex.
No, thank you. And I'm sorry to Kyle, I didn't get to you, buddy. But these guys help me out when they need it, and gal, so. But thank you for your support, kid. Yeah. You and me, buddy.
The next subject is worth $300,000. Pick one, Alex.
Third grade English, that's my man.
The $300,000 third grade English question is going to be revealed when we come back.
I had a feeling that was coming.
Welcome back to Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader? Our contestant, Alex Alfred, has $175,000. Now, I will say, Alex, to get to $175,000, you had to be saved once.
Yes, I did.
By 10-year-olds, and you had to cheat twice.
Yeah.
You proud of yourself?
Heck yeah.
You said you wanted to see the next question.
Yes.
The $300,000 third grade English question is, what is the simple past tense of the verb drink? Your classmates cannot help you anymore.
Well, the easy answer is drank. The alcoholic answer is drunk.
But the important question is, what is the poker player answer?
Fold. What is the simple past tense of the verb drink? I drank a cup of water. He drunk himself stupid. Drank him. It has to be drank. Wow.
You get it wrong, you drop out of school.
I know.
I'm not.
See, here's the thing about poker, Jeff.
We're not playing poker. We're playing. Are you smarter than a fifth grader?
The problem is risking $150,000 in order to earn another $125,000. That's the problem I just have to deal with really quickly here, because that's not a decision I would normally make. Because 175 is really cool. Okay, I'm just gonna see if I can talk myself into being the answer I don't think it is.
You have 30 seconds.
Thank
and
you.
I need an answer.
Simple past tense. I have to do it. Baby, I gotta do it. It's, the answer is drank. Don't let this be the trick question. I know it's drank, but darn it, you never know. Oh, the long walk back to me.
Golly, it's just such a long way from 175 to 25. You said it could either be drank or it could be drunk. Remember that?
Yeah, I remember that.
Gotta be one of the two.
It's the simple one.
It's the sober one. It is drank. You have $300,000.
Freak me out, dude.
You got $300,000.
I could do this.
You're a professional poker player.
Yes, I am.
You said the best day you ever had at professional poker was just under 200,000. And one day here, you have topped the best day you've ever had at work. All right. You've got $300,000. You have no help left from your classmates.
Nope.
You have no choices left on the board. We are down to fifth grade earth science. For $500,000, here's the question. Which element comprises the majority of the Earth's atmosphere? Which element comprises the majority?
I think I know it. No, I want to know it.
Atmosphere. You have $300,000. You think you know it.
Yeah.
You think you know it.
No, I know it, and that's why I'm freaked out.
If you think you know it and you're wrong.
I know, I gotta go back down to 25.
You're giving back over $250,000.
That's true.
What do you think it is?
Well, first let me quote my fiance when she said, hey, it's 25,000 more than we had when we got here.
Okay, you know it.
Okay.
I can tell you this.
I'm not going to do impulsively.
I've been married 22 years, and I sure would hate to go home tonight and say, honey, I just lost over $250,000.
Wow. Well, I'll tell you, man. I think the answer is nitrogen. Most folks think that it's oxygen, but when the atmosphere is very, very large, and the oxygen's down here. Most of the atmosphere is up there, and there's not much oxygen. I believe it's about 3/4 nitrogen.
You want to lock that in?
I'll do that in just a sec. I got to make sure. Don't go putting pressure on me. I just need to think of, is there some other element in play here?
You need a little oxygen right now?
Yeah. I gotta do it, sweetheart. It's nitrogen. I can't even believe I just risked $275,000.
I will tell you this. Your five classmates over here that helped you get this far have three different answers.
I believe it.
Which element comprises the majority of the Earth's atmosphere? $500,000. The answer's coming up right after this. Welcome back to Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader? Our contestant, Alex Alfred, has $300,000. He's playing for $500,000. Golly, $300,000.
I know, man. I had to hold him, though, man. I had aces. I knew it. I hope.
The question was, which element comprises the majority of the Earth's atmosphere? Your buddy Spencer, who helped you out, said oxygen.
It's all right.
You said nitrogen.
Correct.
Three quarters of the Earth's atmosphere is made of nitrogen.
Give me that vote.
You're making my hands sweat. It's not even my money. You've got $500,000. Almost triple the best day you ever had at poker.
That's about right.
There's an 11th question up there.
Okay.
You can get no help on the million-dollar question.
Correct.
Once you see the question, you have to answer. You may see the subject, but if you ask to see the question, you're all in, okay? For $1 million. The subject is U.S. history. So if you're gonna walk away and drop out of school, you need to do it now.
Here's the thing. U.S. history is my favorite subject.
You can do this! You can do this!
$500,000.
Here's the deal. If I get this wrong, I'm history. So, calling it quits at 500,000.
You lock it in?
Calling it quits. Done.
That's a heck of a work day.
That's a good work day.
Congratulations, Alex.
Thank you.
All right, you want to have a little fun?
Yeah, I want to see that question, man.
The million-dollar question is, who was the first U.S. Secretary of the Treasury?
Alexander Hamilton.
That's right, you would have made $1 million. Would have been our first millionaire, but the gambler didn't want to gamble. $500,000 is a pretty good day's work. You remember our deal. Look in the camera and tell the world.
I am smart enough to take the money, but I'm not smarter than a fifth grader.
Congratulations, Alex. Good job, class. We'll see you next time on Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader?
Greater.
$1 million. All they have to do is prove that they are smarter than a fifth grader. It's that easy. All right, let's meet our class. Kyle, Jacob, Alana, Spencer, and Marty. Well, you know, in most schools, if a child is not there, it means they're sick. In our classroom, Laura, who was at that desk, got a call from the Fox Network, and she is on a new sitcom, and so Marky is our newest member of the classroom. Are you having fun so far, Marky?
Yes, a lot of fun.
Well, we sure are glad to have you. You guys ready to meet our first student?
Yeah!
He is a 26-year-old watch salesman who attended Conway Middle School in Orlando, Florida. Welcome, John Zoll! John, welcome to the show. You're in a good mood today,
John. I'm in a great mood.
And I'm guessing this is a photo of you when you attended Conway Middle School?
Yes, yes it is.
And apparently borrowed your sister's shirt for picture day. And it says your most embarrassing moment in the fifth grade was you were beaten up by the neighborhood bully, Tiffany.
Thanks, Jeff.
You got beat up by a girl?
Yeah, he got,
yeah,
beat,
I got
up
beat up by a girl.
All right, John, these are your new classmates. They're going to be taking the same test you're taking. Pick one of them, and let's get started.
Kyle.
Kyle, come on up here.
Let's do this, buddy.
John, let me tell you how this little game works. On the board, you're going to see 10 subjects. They range from first grade through the fifth grade. You can pick them in any order you like. Your first correct answer is worth $1,000. The 10th question, should you answer it correctly, is worth $500,000. Yeah. John, once you ace this test, we're going to give you one more question. It will be worth $1 million.
$1 million.
If at any point the fifth grade gets to be too difficult today, you can drop out of school. You can take the money and run, but before you leave, I want you to promise me you'll look into that camera and tell millions and millions of people I am not smarter than a fifth grader.
I'll do it.
We got a deal.
We
All
got
right.
A deal.
Let's find out, is John Zoll smarter than a fifth grader? Woo! All right, John. 10 subjects. We got to get them all if we're going to win a million. Pick your first one.
What are you good at, Kyle?
Social studies, science, geography, and history.
Social studies, science, geography, and history, Kyle said.
I think I'm good at social studies. I think we'll go with first grade social studies.
First grade social studies. All right, John. The $1,000 question is, what is the name of the following landmark, which is located in our nation's capital? What is the name of the following landmark, which is located in our nation's capital? Now, I told you your classmates could help you. Let me tell you how. You have two cheats. You can peek off of their paper once during the game. You can copy their paper, and you have one save, which means if you're wrong, but your classmate at the podium's right, they save you, and we keep going on down the road. Kyle has locked in his answer. What you thinking, John?
Ooh, well, there's quite a few monuments in Washington, D.C.
There are.
And I think I'm going to go with the Washington Monument.
Here's the good news. If you're wrong and Kyle's right, he can save you. But he doesn't have to, because you're right, you have $1,000.
$1,000, baby. That's what I'm talking about, Kyle.
That's what I'm talking about. $1,000's good. $2,000's better.
Even better.
$2,000's better. Pick another subject, John.
I'm going to go with first grade grammar.
First grade grammar. Here is the $2,000 question, John. True or false? The word monsters is the subject in the following sentence. The idea of monsters living under his bed kept Kyle awake at night.
What? True or false?
The word monsters is the subject in the following sentence. The idea of monsters living under his bed kept Kyle awake at night.
Uh-oh.
Kyle has locked in his answer. The first grade is a little rough.
The idea of
I mean, this is a question that's normally answered by people who can stick their whole arm in a box of cereal and pull the prize out of the bottom.
I could do that. And I like doing that.
I could do that. I could stick my entire arm in a box of cereal.
I think I'm going to take an educated guess here, Jeff, and I'm going to say false.
The answer's false. You got
$2,000.
You got to pick another classmate now, John. Kyle's got to return to the room.
I'm going to go with Marky.
Marky, come on up here. All right, is the newest member of the class, has the rest of the class been nice to you?
Yes.
Being the new kid? I would hope so. You want to see something funny?
Yes.
We have a surprise video from his school. Oh! I heard that John was a band geek in school. Here is the band. Take a look, John.
Hey, John, I'm Keith Nichols, the band director at Conway Middle School, home of the proud and positive Falcons. We're here to support you in your quest to win $1 million. Oh. Here's a little school spirit from Orlando, Florida. One, two, three, four.
That's our theme song. That's our theme song, John!
Yes!
Thank you, Conway Middle School.
Now, I can't let them down.
You can't.
I can't.
You got 2,000. I got a feeling they want to see you go further than that. Pick another subject. Let's turn it into 5,000, John.
Let's go with second grade measurements.
Second grade measurements for $5,000. Our question is, Jacob left his home for school at 7:45 a.m. and returned home the same day at 3:45 p.m. How many hours was he gone? Jacob left his home for school at 7:45 a.m. and he returned home the same day at 3:45 p.m. How many hours was he gone? It says on your card you're a watch salesman.
I am.
I mean, this is right up your alley. You're a watch salesman.
It is.
Marky has locked in her answer.
8:45, 9:45, 10:45,
11:45,
12:45, 1:45, 2:45,
2:45. You need
another
hand?
Make sure I can. Okay. I think I'm going to answer it myself, and I'm going to say 8 hours.
You got 5,000. We'll be right back playing for $10,000 right after this.
Coming up on Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader? Jumping John skipped past the first grade. But now things are getting pretty tough.
You're gonna give me a heart attack.
Can John sweat it out all the way to $1 million?
I better win $1 million.
Don't miss it.
Our contestant, John Zoll, has got $5,000. We are about to play for $10,000. Seven subjects remaining. Pick one of them, John.
Let's go for second grade animal science.
Second grade animal science. For $10,000, John, here is the question. The female of what animal is called a ewe? The female of what animal is called a ewe? Marky has locked in her answer. Do you think you know the answer?
I do think I know the answer. Jeff, I'm going to say sheep.
No other animal on the farm crossed your mind?
No.
You have $10,000.
Yes!
A ewe is a female sheep.
Thank you, Marky. Woo!
Marky has to return to the classroom.
You're gonna give me a heart attack.
We are playing for $25,000. You need to pick another classmate.
Jacob.
Jacob.
I like orange, Jacob. I like your shirt.
John, you brought some people here today to root for you?
I did.
Who do you have?
I have my beautiful wife, Stacy.
Hi, Stace. How far do you think he's gonna go today?
We're going on the $1 million so we can get a boat.
$1 million. You got 6 subjects left for us to work our way to the top of this ladder.
We're going with third grade U.S. geography.
Third grade U.S. geography. All right. For $25,000, here is the third grade U.S. geography question. The following is an outline of what U.S. state? This is an outline of what U.S. state? Jacob locked in his answer. What you thinking?
I'm thinking Nebraska. Give it up. $25,000! Woo! What are you thinking? Yeah!
You pretty confident with that answer?
I am very confident in that answer.
Almost cocky.
Yes, very cocky.
Cocky.
I'm a gifted student, Jeff. Come on.
Well, here is a little gift for you. You got $25,000. John, you are jumping around like a cricket on a hot plate. For $50,000, pick another subject, John.
Let's go with fourth grade world geography.
Fourth grade world geography. The fourth grade world geography question is...
$50,000.
Bern is the capital of what European country? Bern is the capital of what European country? Jacob is locked in. He answered quickly. You could peek at his paper. You don't have to go with it.
This is too much money to risk just going for it, so I'm gonna use my peek.
Peek. Question. Bern is the capital of what European country? Your 10-year-old classmate said Switzerland.
I sell watches.
You sell
They're
watches?
They're all made in Switzerland. Probably something I should know.
If that's the right answer.
If it's the right answer.
Tick-tock.
I'm gonna say Switzerland and go with Jacob's answer.
Let's see what the class said. The class said Bern is the capital of what European country? Switzerland. The answer, Switzerland!
Yeah!
thank you very, very much.
Jacob has got to return to the classroom. We are down to four subjects. You only have two classmates left. You only have four subjects left. Pick one of them. Let's go after it.
Alana.
Alana.
Yeah!
Alana, there's only four subjects left. If you had to help him with two of them, which two would you pick?
Astronomy and... That's pretty much it.
Astronomy, and that's pretty much it.
Third grade astronomy it is.
Third grade astronomy.
For $100,000, oh my God.
The $100,000 question is coming up when we come back. Our contestant, John Zoll, has got $50,000. We're getting up in the big money. You selected third grade astronomy. The $100,000 question is, true or false, light is the only thing that can escape a black hole. True or false? Light is the only thing that can escape a black hole.
You know what?
Alana's locked in.
Jeff, light is very quick. But not even light can escape a black hole. False. Wow. Woo! I'm pretty sure on that one.
Alana thinks that you're right, because she said the same thing, so she cannot save you.
Ooh.
How did you come up with that answer?
50-50? Come on!
50-50 is the way you selected false?
I think
I'm right. So fast. I mean, we didn't even talk about the strategy.
It's the first thing that popped into my head.
Would you get excited if I said you had $100,000?
I bet, yeah. That's a pretty good certainty.
How high would you jump?
Probably high enough to hurt myself.
Let's see it, because you got $100,000.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah! Love, baby, love! Love, love, love! Woo! Woo! $100,000! Woo!
John. We're playing for $175,000. You have one fourth grade question. You have two fifth grade questions remaining. John, before I ask you this question, because I'm learning, you have a copy left. You have a save left. Or you can walk away. Let's talk about this before you slap the silver button, all right? Because $100,000 is a lot of money, John.
$100,000.
What are you going to do with this kind of money?
I'm going to buy us a custom 35-foot-long pontoon boat.
Really? A party boat.
Redneck Yacht Club.
Redneck Yacht Club. You can do that with $100,000.
I can.
With $175,000, you can throw some nasty parties on that thing. Pick a subject. What you thinking?
I'm thinking that
you
I'm...
You ask your wife?
Yes.
What do you think, Stacy?
History.
History, she said.
I'm going to go with my fifth grade U.S. history.
John, the $175,000 question is, what man who would later be U.S. president represented the British soldiers who were on trial for the Boston Massacre? What man who would later be U.S. president represented the British soldiers who were on trial for the Boston Massacre? Alana locked in her answer.
I used to know this, too.
Used to know it.
Used to know it. It flew
away.
Like
my mother always said, your father used to be an attractive man. Don't hit the button.
I'm not going to hit the button.
If you were to go with your gut, what would you say?
If I had to pick an answer, I would say John Adams. If I had to.
You're a daring guy. It says on your card you also fly a helicopter.
I do. I'm a helicopter pilot.
You've been in the military.
Yep. This is
scary. A couple of tours of duty, actually. And this is scary.
Yeah.
The fifth grade.
Well, it had to be one of the first couple of presidents. Had to be Jefferson wrote the penance. Was it Adams? Oh, John Quincy Adams. John Adams.
Talk it out. What do you think? You're a smart guy. What are you thinking?
I think it's got to be one of the first couple of presidents. Either, you know, I know it's not George Washington, but Thomas Jefferson is a maybe, but I don't think it's him either. I keep wanting to say John Adams, but I'm not sure if that's right.
Yeah, it couldn't have been Washington because he'd never told a lie, so he couldn't have been a lawyer.
And even if it is John Adams, I know there was John Adams and John Quincy Adams, and if I had to pick one, I have no idea.
They've got a prom to get to in just a few years.
You know, Jeff, I'm here for the money, and I got a save left, so I'm gonna say John Adams. Great of God, great of God, please, please.
Stacey.
Did I really just do that?
He just said, did I really just do that? You were saying, do not take a guess.
I was saying that.
And what did he do?
He always does the opposite of what I say. I should have known.
That's called being a husband. He just took a guess.
He sure did.
You said,
oh, come on,
John Adams, you said if you don't get it right, maybe Alana can save you. Let's see what Alana said. Alana said, James Madison.
Ooh, that sounds better.
You like hers better? If you had it to do all over again, you would have said James Madison.
Probably.
If you had it to do all over again and you said James Madison, John, you would be wrong.
Oh, no, 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 no.
The answer to what man would later be U.S. president represented the British soldiers who were on trial for the Boston Massacre is coming up when we come back.
No! No!
Welcome back to Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader? Our contestant, John Zoll, has decided to answer the $175,000 question. You said, well, I'm gonna guess, and if I'm wrong, maybe Alana could save me.
She's wrong.
The question is, what man would later be U.S. president represented the British soldiers who were on trial for the Boston Massacre? She said James Madison. You said, ooh, I like that answer better. I told you she was wrong. Let's see what the class said. These guys can't save you either, but for giggles, let's see what they said. I don't know. George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, and Washington.
This is not
Did you
good.
Think of Thomas Jefferson?
I thought about him, but I didn't think it was him.
Okay. You didn't think. I was shocked that you decided to guess at this question. You said John Adams. The answer to what man would later be U.S. president represented the British soldiers who were on trial for the Boston Massacre is John Adams.
In me, Jeff.
You don't know how much you've got left in you. Alana has got to return to the classroom. We're down to the last two subjects. Spencer.
I will try to help as much as I can.
Your wife is crying.
I'm going to cry.
Stacy, what do you want him to do at this point?
Walk away.
Walk away.
Just one more. One more. Always one more.
In the words of a true junkie, just one more. I want to see you win $1 million.
I want to.
You can see the question.
I can.
And still walk
away. And walk away.
Pick a subject.
Well, I think we're going to go with fifth grade literature.
Listen to the question carefully before you answer.
Back away from the button.
Back away from the button. The $300,000 question is, Mark Twain is the pseudonym of what famous American author who wrote The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn? Mark Twain is the pseudonym of what famous American author who wrote The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn? I almost said hound. Spencer has locked in his answer.
I'm considering my first gut instinct, which was to yell copy and smack the button as hard as I could. And I grabbed my wrist because I didn't want my wife to come flying out of the audience.
How long you been married?
2 years.
You learn quickly.
Yes.
You have a copy left.
I do have a copy and a save.
You have a save left.
I would hate to walk away and waste my cheats when I could go further.
Leaving here with a cheat on the board is a dilemma.
It is.
But it's not a shame. Yeah, giving back $150,000 is a shame. You want a second to think about this?
Yes, I do.
All right. We're gonna find out whether John Zoll goes for $300,000 when we come back. Welcome back to Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader? Our contestant, John Zoll, has seen the $300,000 question. The question is, Mark Twain is the pseudonym of what famous American author who wrote The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn? You said you wanted to think about it, so we went to a commercial. Your eyes are tearing up. We've reached the hour of decision. I want you to win $1 million. I don't want to see you give money back. You've got your copy left. You could copy his paper. He answered quickly, and he's a smart kid. You've got a save left. Or you could walk out of here right now with $175,000. What are you thinking? Do you have anything coming to your mind on this one?
A great American general once said, advance, advance, never retreat. I'm going to copy. All or nothing, man. It's all or nothing.
John. Does Samuel Clemens ring a bell?
I like Samuel Clemens. That rings a nice big bell.
That's because it's the right answer. All that matters now is what this 10-year-old with the freckles wrote down.
Woo!
For $300,000, show us what Spencer wrote. He said, Samuel Clemens!
Yes! Thank you very much.
Here's the problem. Spencer is now so dizzy, he can't help you anymore.
We're in the same boat then.
John, when we started this quiz, there were 10 subjects. We're down to one.
Just another test. Just another
John,
test.
John, you have now used both of your cheats. You only have your save left, okay? That's a good thing to have.
It is.
This question is worth $500,000.
$500,000. $500,000.
$500,000. That's nothing. I want to see you leave here with at least $300,000.
$300,000.
Do not hit this too quickly. The 10th question on this quiz is a fourth grade math question.
I've never been so scared.
Were you good at math?
I'm decent at math.
Decent at math.
Not great, but not horrible. I got 10 fingers, and I might have to take off my shoes.
I've seen that before. And I'm really hoping we don't have to count to 21.
Multiples of 10.
John Zoll. The $500,000 question is, what is the sum of 11.5 and negative 14? What is the sum of 11.5 and negative 14? Spencer has locked in his answer. What you thinking, John?
I'm thinking that I have to go backwards. Because once numbers hit zero, they start going higher. A little hyphen in front of them.
Count it out loud.
14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, and plus 12 would be minus 2, but it's 11.5, so it's gonna be negative 2.5.
$500,000! $500,000!
With the same.
John, that was the most bizarre display of hillbilly arithmetic I have ever seen in my life. I'll tell you this.
14, 13.
He can't save you. You know why? Spencer said
13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 10,
negative 2.5 with two question marks. How many question marks did you have after your answer, John?
None. One of them gut things.
One of them gut things. You seem to do that a lot. You said you wanted a 35-foot boat. Your wife's about to throw up. I got some bad news. You need a bigger garage because you're going to have to buy a bigger car. You've got $500,000, John. Good job.
$500,000.
You have $500,000. You have $500,000, John. Do you need to sit down?
Yes.
He needs to sit there. Jacob, can he sit at you? There we go.
Here, here. Go ahead. Go ahead, Ben. Ben. Ben, you can use my desk. Come on.
I'm good.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Do we need to call the school nurse?
Carmen up.
Hey, do me a favor.
What do you need, Jeff?
Tell me what the board says.
$1 million question.
It says $1 million question. And we're gonna see it when we come back. John. Let's set this up. Our 26-year-old watch salesman has answered all 10 questions on the quiz. We are down to the, say it with me,
$1 million question.
John, up until this point, you were allowed to see the question and then decide if you wanted to walk away or not. With the $1 million question, I can show you the subject, but if you decide to see the question, you must answer. If you answer this question incorrectly, you don't walk out of here with $1 million, you walk out with $25,000. What are you thinking right now?
I want to see the subject only right now.
The subject only. The subject of the $1 million question is fifth grade math.
Oh, I might be able to do this. I might be able to do this.
Fifth grade math. Now, you did good on the fourth grade math question.
I did.
You did?
I did.
It was funky math. But you got it right.
$1 million. $1 million. $500.
No help from the fifth graders. No cheats. Just you and a fifth grade math question.
For $1 million.
For $1 million.
$1 million.
Or you can walk out of here with $500,000.
I got $500,000. And I have a beautiful wife who I would like to go sleep in the same house with tonight. And I'm dropping out of school, Jeff.
Fun as anybody we've ever had on the show.
Thank you very much.
Four giggles.
Oh, no.
Do you want to see the question?
Yes, I do.
You do? For giggles. Because you almost did it, didn't you?
I did.
Almost went.
My gut said smack the button.
Your gut says smack the button every time. John, the $1 million question would have been, what is the only prime number that is a factor of 16?
$500,000, baby!
Do you know the answer to this?
No, I do not.
The only prime number that's a factor of 16 is 2.
2.
John Zoll, you have got $500,000! Remember the one little promise you made me so long ago here.
Yes, I do, Jeff.
There's the camera.
My name is John Zoll. I fly helicopters. I've been around the world. I'm worth $500,000, and I am not smarter than a fifth grader.
But you got $500,000.